the Trump National Golf Club in beautiful Rancho Palos Verdes, California. Just a few clicks down the Pacific Coast Highway from Malibu, and a hop, skip, and a jump south by southwest of bustling Los Angeles. A match over the back nine holes between the winner of 27 professional tournaments, Australian Adam Scott, owner of golf's most natural swing, and a veteran player known for his win in the Open at St. Andrews and his incredible comeback victory in the PGA Championship, Arkansas native son John Daly, who became the first professional golfer to average more than 300 yards per drive in a season. To analyze today's match for us, the legendary little pro, Eddie Merritts, and golf personality, Gary Williams.
This is going to be very interesting.
And they're contrasting styles, contrasting personalities. We should have some fun with those two.
Arby's presents the Adult Swim Golf Classic, John Daly versus Adam Scott. Arby's, we have the meats. This week, Trump National Golf Club in Rancho Palos Verdes, California. Southern California is home to some of the world's finest golf courses, and Trump National is no exception. A beautifully manicured course, blessed with that famous Southern California weather. Look, it's head caddy, Michael Anderson, prepping his boys for a hard day's work.
I want the tees in between each groove. There, information at the ready.
And there's Old Glory. She's a beaut, ain't she? And a great indicator of wind direction. And wind is just one of many challenges this course holds in store. For Trump National itself is internationally known for its challenging terrain. An avid surfer, Adam Scott, must be enjoying his time on this south-facing coastline. And here it is, the Green Blazer itself, complete with the prettiest hangar I ever did see, Adam's wife, Poppy.
Kids are here, they're enjoying themselves back at the
Back at the hotel.
I believe there's a swimming pool.
There's Arkansas native John Daly, giving a local fan a thrill. Though he has become known for a series of international boners, John Daly is a true blue pro golf journeyman. And there's John's brand new bride, Norita. Norita is from Cambodia, a tiny country just west of South Vietnam.
Really excited to be here in Rancho Palos Verdes. Really excited to play this tournament.
And now to interview Adam and John, the winner of every golf tournament there is, Jim Shea.
We're here at the first tee waiting for our match to get underway. We'd like to take this opportunity to remind you that our players are competing today for a total of $15,000 in prize money. $10,000 to the winner's charity, $5,000 to the loser, and $7,500 to each in the event of a tie. And now the players approach the first tee. Mr. Adam Scott in his mock turtleneck and Mr. John Daly in his eye-popping attire. Gentlemen, so good to have you with us here today. Now, Adam, everyone knows you're a native of Australia, and I'm curious how this course stacks up to the ones in your homeland.
Well, sure. I look out here and I see the same Pacific Ocean I grew up looking at in Australia.
Oh, that sounds like an idyllic childhood. Over to Long John Daly. You have been striking the ball extremely well, haven't you?
I'm pretty proud of some of my drives. Let's hope some of them go a little bit closer to the hole there.
Indeed. Well, gentlemen, if you're ready to tee off, we are. We want to wish you the best of luck on this very difficult course. So if you'll step over to the tee box, we'll have the coin toss and get things underway.
Adam Scott won the coin toss, officiated by golf legend Arthur Boyce. Then it was hands over their hearts, paying respect to Old Glory before kicking off the game. Playing the back nine, the players start at hole 10, a 440-yard par 4. With a ceremonial tee-off from retired great Walt Parrish, we now join our sports commentators, Gary Williams and Eddie Merritts.
And welcome to what we think is going to be a very special day of golf. Gary Williams alongside the legendary Eddie Merritts. Today, these two men, both major champions, John Daly and, of course, Adam Scott, they have a very different approach to the way they play the game of golf.
They certainly do, and it'll be fun to see the contrast depicted today.
Beautiful.
That's a wonderful start, is it not?
Great shot.
Hey.
Yeah, it's just the short par 4 and play it out to the right, the conservative route, but maybe John would make an opening statement and maybe try to take this green on.
All right, Con.
All right, okay.
Just wonder if that's going to clear the ravine.
Well done.
Indeed it did.
Okay.
So we're off.
There we go.
And Eddie's got a little bit of a hanging lie here for this second shot.
You make two allowances when you have an off-balance lie like that. One for your sake of balance, and two for the gravity pull on the ball.
A In three chips, John was on the green by way of the bunkers on the left side, while Adam took two strokes, approaching from the right fairway.
Well, Eddie, John's got this lengthy 25-footer for double bogey.
He started off fairly well, but things have gone downhill for him since then.
And he has hit that awfully firm.
Good putt, John.
A little too much wind on that one.
Yeah.
These are fast greens, though. It's hard California sand clay.
John, it's still your putt.
Oh, it's mine?
There's an idea.
Don't tell me how to play golf, man.
Always playing to the crowd, isn't
it? What is it, seven?
Yeah.
On my way to a snowman up here.
Good roll, John.
John finished the hole in 10 strokes. Here's Adam.
Now, interesting to note, Eddie, he's got that long putter, and as we all know, soon enough, that's going to be an illegal instrument in the game.
Not long for this world.
No, it isn't. Now, Adam, this is one of the most interesting ways to read a green that I've ever seen. Have you ever seen anything like this?
There's a word for it in Australia. God knows what it means in the U.S.
These two men couldn't be more different. Backgrounds, personality. Oh, mercy.
Whoops.
That is a three putt from 6 feet.
At the end of hole 10, Daly at 6 over par and Scott at 2 over par. On hole 11, finding the deep bunkers in front usually spells bogey or worse. The ocean beyond the green makes for some difficult decisions, so club selection is critical.
Eddie, we've moved on to the par 3 11th, 225 yards. What a gorgeous view. He's clearly laying up.
Was a tropical heat wave of him?
A little hot under the collar, huh, John?
Hey, maybe. Ribbit or ribbit!
What club are you using?
Hey! Come on, man.
Sorry, I didn't realize you were...
That shot looked like your shot.
Adam's ball was up against the tree line, forcing him to swing lefty. Unfortunately, it left him whiffing in the grass. And when he finally got a piece of the ball, it went straight into the Pacific blue.
A little too much pepper on that one.
John hit his ball sideways into the sand track, causing him to throw his club in anger.
It was sideways.
Damn!
But in only 2 strokes, he was out of the sand, causing him to throw his club again, this time in celebration, and head to the green where Adam was taking his drop.
Fascinating to see him drop onto the green. And I think John is referencing that putter, which will be banned soon enough. That's pretty good speed. He's going to leave himself about 3 feet.
Good putt.
I believe with the penalty stroke that was assessed to John in the bunker, he is now putting for 8.
Good roll, John.
And that's a pretty good effort right
there. Good stroke.
Maybe the first bow I've ever seen for a double-digit result on a par 3. Both men really struggled on that hole.
Hole 12. 530 yards out, this downhill hole is reachable in 2 for most players.
That might have been his best practice swing of the day. Whatever that's worth. That's a good swing.
All right, John.
His pre-shot routine has been different with every swing. This is peculiar.
All right. Yeah. Wonderful shot. Great shot.
Well, splits the fairway. Guess that stupid thing you did paid off.
John hit his ball out of bounds, which sent him packing. Even the pros have to search for their ball sometimes.
Adam's getting ready to play his third here. He has about 155 to the front.
God damn it.
My ball's dirty.
Okay, we can't pick it up.
Can't touch it?
No, you're gonna have to play it as is.
We're gonna play it where it lies.
John won 2 major championships. He doesn't know that he can't touch his golf ball.
Lucky selected. Yeah. 8 iron, would you say?
He almost thinks the spectators are mocking him. I don't think this young man needs to run in to identify his golf ball. It went about 9 feet. But that kid's just doing his job.
He's doing his job.
That's well
better,
struck.
Better, better.
It's going to come down to the short game.
There we go.
That's what I wanted.
Good shot.
That's not too bad.
Good shot.
Leave himself uphill.
Good shot for Scott. Good Scott.
8 feet.
Want some good Scott?
He's playing five right now. They're approaching this hole.
Excuse me. Stepped on my lie. Stepped on my lie.
Excuse me. No, I did not.
There's a dent. Right here. There's a dent right there.
I see no dent there.
That's a stroke, right?
Hold on, guys. This is for charity, remember.
John's confused again about the rules. That's purely etiquette. There's no rules violation for
Adam
walking on someone's line.
We're going to play it.
We're going to play
it. Hey,
guys, we're going to play it, all right?
Let's go. Maybe we should just play the game.
They should shut up. Get a life.
Oh!
These kids better like this money they're getting.
John Daly struggled on the green, while Adam Scott found a way to struggle even more.
Oh, I'm sick of this small ball. Bullshit!
Now a word from our sponsor, Arby's. Arby's, we have the meats. We now return to the Adult Swim Golf Classic, brought to you by Arby's. Arby's, we have the meats.
On the 13th hole, a long 445 yards, Daly and Scott hacked their way to the fairway. Adam chose a 6-iron to get him within putting distance, while John used a 3-iron, taking baby steps, both breaking even on the hole with 6 putts each. Hole 14 is a beautiful yet nasty par 5. It was dubbed Inferno Verde, or the Green Hell, by greenskeeper Levenstein. In 12 strokes, Adam found himself on the green near the far bunker, and in 5 swings, John was faced with a hanging lie in the bunker to the left.
Yeah, why don't you just take the sand wedge, hit it out towards Adam's wall, play it safe.
I'm not going to play it safe, Pee-wee. I'm going to play it dangerous. Get your head on. I love that guy.
Now, if it's easy or hard to caddy for John Daly.
Okay.
There we go. That's good. That's pretty good.
Is that good?
John said that's pretty good. Based on what we've seen on this hole, that is one of the greatest shots in the history of the game.
Slap shot.
Go in there. Not bad.
Pretty good speed, Eddie.
That was a good putt.
All right.
He actually kissed his ball after making what is likely 25 to 28 strokes on this hole.
On hole 15, John outplayed Adam by a whopping 9 strokes. Checking in with the scores, it's 45 over par for John Daly and 55 over par for Adam Scott. Hole 16. 338-yard par 4. The green is fronted by a pond, but there is ample landing area in the fairway and a late dogleg left.
It's a very awkward stance.
4!
Couple that with him having about 4 belts.
Yeah. Sand bunker.
No!
Uh-oh.
And he's got a fairway wood. You like this club choice?
I think it's a horrible choice. Don't tell him what kind of... Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
Fun.
Adam hit his ball into the hazard, close to where John was taking his 4th stroke.
There's plenty of green he can work with, playing out to the right.
Damn it!
Uh-oh. Oh, my God.
Shut up!
It just scared the duck right out of the pond.
Give me another 7.
That's the only 7 we have.
Whoa. Hang on.
Well, it appears the rules official is alerting him that he cannot replace that club.
Well, he just threw the club away intentionally, which means the club, for all intent and purpose, is lost. So he can't ask for a replacement club.
Eddie, he's going into the lake.
No.
It's way out there, John.
He's wading into the middle of this pond. Eddie, he has a lot of sad chapters on his resume. Where does this one rank?
You all right?
It's got to be right at the top, Gary.
He just submerged himself into the middle of this lake. Ducks are flying away.
Yeah!
Hey, look at that. Found that golf club.
The boys are almost finished on this beautiful hole 17. After a quick wardrobe change, John checked in with his lovely wife, Marita.
Rita, you need a beer or anything?
No, I think maybe I had enough for ever. You know, it's like a lot.
Go back to the hotel.
It's okay?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, I don't want you to feel like I'm leaving you, you know?
I don't.
I want to support you.
No, no, you're being supportive. I understand. It's pretty boring. Pretty boring game. Love you.
Love you too.
All right.
Win, huh?
Okay. You guys want to go out to dinner sometime?
What's that?
Double date.
Oh, for dinner?
Yeah, you want to go to Rancho Palos Verdes?
That'd be terrific.
Great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is without question the finest struck ball of the day.
Here's John about to unleash his big drive. He's currently 5 strokes ahead of Adam.
Get a mulligan on that?
He said mulligan, Eddie, but that's a penalty stroke for a lost ball.
He drops 2, shooting 3. He drops 4, shooting 5.
He's just invoked the double mulligan.
He's completely lost his lead. That's sure.
John finally hit his ball over the chasm, but it had him struggling 5 strokes deep in the sand. And then, a miracle.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
There you go. Look at that. Oh!
That's the shot of the day.
Hey,
a hand match. It went right into the hole.
That shot, you fake golf man. Thanks a lot.
Hole 18. Seaside cliffs loom to the left of the wide two-tiered fairway, though the centerpiece of this hole is the tee, an elevated throne overlooking Pacific blue.
We could just hit a diner.
A diner would be fine, John. I know I've been talking about Mexican food, but I do like a cheeseburger every now and then, and I know Poppy doesn't mind them either.
Yeah, I mean, cool. Well, we could also just plan it later when we're done with the game and...
I guess we could get the wives talking about it. Maybe they could come up with some ideas.
This is hard.
It's very hard.
Look at the bunkers.
Yeah, I mean...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There must be 20 bunkers in that.
Heck, John, why don't you give it a shot?
All right, well, there ain't nothing to do but to...
Yep.
Hit this ball. Oh, man.
All right, well...
Yeah.
After struggling with the distance, the boys decide to tee off a little closer at the women's tee.
Well, Eddie... Gentlemen's agreement that they decided not to play the back tee.
I mean, from over there? Come on.
That's crazy. That's a big distance, man. Back in Dardanelle, we used to have a saying, even blind squirrels get some nuts.
Sure. Can you shut up for a second?
That is rolling down the cart path. He's gaining distance with every step.
Hey. It's been a pleasure.
Yeah,
another handshake. It all comes down to this. These two men, hard to believe, they're actually tied.
This one's from Rancho Palos Verdes. Oh!
Okay.
Better than Adam.
Yeah, down,
better.
Down the fairway.
And he drops his club. And I think this crowd is applauding because it's almost over.
You're a good guy, though.
Yeah, you too, man, I think.
No, there's a certain magic that happens with golf in this time of day. There's just a certain magic. Sometimes things happen that you never expect.
That's a pretty profound statement from someone like John, is it not?
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Well, he advanced it about 18
Could be worse.
Yards.
Could be worse. Just kiss it. Just kiss it. Just give it a kiss. Kiss it. Just kiss it.
Oh, mercy.
Uh-oh.
That is,
Thank you.
Now Adam has an opportunity to gain an advantage.
Uh-oh.
Well, now he's absolutely goosed that one. This match is far from over.
Might be the deciding shot, Gary.
Whoa. And Adam has hit this well past the
overshot
hole.
It.
They out. Oh my God, he's put it in the ocean.
Sit!
That might go all the way off the green if it reaches that one last little false front.
Lucky.
Skilly.
Well, Adam is going ahead and putting and doesn't even touch the hole 30 feet to win this match. He's left it woefully short. He's halfway to the hole.
We're going
a little harder.
And Adam, who, for someone who has won a major championship, is putting his ball back down.
Tap in with that hockey stick.
Oh, he barely got it.
Only 8 feet out. Sinking this putt would mean a tie game.
This is just a tap in, right? I don't have to do this.
You should do it.
If John makes
this, why would he not have to do this?
This match is complete, Eddie. It's finally over.
It is over.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of our charity back nine. John Daly, Adam Scott.
That was all right.
That was a whole lot of fun.
And on behalf of my colleagues Eddie Marins and Gary Williams, I can honestly say we've never seen anything like it on any golf course anywhere in the world.
Just want to again thank Mr. Daly for a fine day of golf.
I'm just glad we could do some good for these charities, and, you know, this is the only trophy I need right here.
And our Back Nine charity winner for this year is Adam Scott, a one-stroke victory over Mr. Daly. And Mr. Scott, as we discussed off the top of the show, received $10,000 to his charity of choice. And our runner-up, Mr. Daly, $5,000 to his charity of choice. And on behalf of everyone at the Charity Back Nine and Trump National Golf Club, we'd like to thank you gentlemen for a very memorable round of golf.
Well, Adam Scott, for John Daly, Eddie, it's been a pleasure to be with you, the legend that you are. I'm Gary Williams. Until next time, and Lord willing, there won't be a next time. We'll see you then.
Thank you, Gary.